c'est un suivant.
Summoner 105, reduce speed to 210 knots. Correct. Correct 671, reduce speed to 210 knots.
The RTL-SDR is a small USB dongle that plugs into your PC and picks up various signals from around you. The company that produces the dongle states the following about it. It's an ultra-cheap software-defined radio. It can be used as a wideband radio scanner. It may interest ham radio enthusiasts, hardware hackers, tinkerers, and anyone interested in radio frequency. At $40, I took the plunge and I bought it and spent a week with it. And in this video, we will cover the basics and how to get started. It's surprisingly easy, but there's so much information about it that it can scare people away. So I have organized it in a simple, easy to digest manner for everyone to understand. There will be detailed timestamps. If you want, you can skip to your desired part. And if you skip, you will find what you're looking for without needing to watch the entire video. However, if you're new, I would highly recommend that you watch the whole video. Let's go. So who is RTL-SDR? Well, it's not a company in the regular sense. Think of it like a large group project. On their website, this is how they identify themselves. No person or company owns RTL-SDR, and it's all supported software and hardware in its entirety. However, it was the combined efforts of Antti Paluzari, Eric Fry, and Osmocom, in particular, Steve Mark Graf, who is first discovered that certain TV dongles can be used for SDR. Osmocom in particular developed the first RTL-SDR driver, which was released as an open source. Understanding radio. Let's quickly understand how radio works, as it will make using the device and software a breeze. You might have heard of AM and FM. They're both similar, meaning you can tune into an AM signal using an FM receiver. The quality might be bad, but it can be done. This means they're interchangeable to a degree. To put it simply, we were only introduced to a small part of radio signals for commercial reasons. All radio signals, whether it's commercial radio channels, weather forecast, aviation communication, and even marine and army signals, can all be picked up by a single device if it's capable enough. All these signals follow two rules: frequency and wavelength. That's why in classic radios from the past, you can find two dials or knobs to adjust them. However, those radios were limited in that they can only pick up AM and FM signals, typically from 88 to 108 megahertz. But the frequency line is much bigger, and there are other types of signals. But why these complications? Why not just have one device for all signals? The answer is simple: clarity and range. Normal radio stations use FM because it's condensed and clear, but travel short distances. But they can recover from the short distance limitation by building signal boosters. Signal boosters will work with aviation services to an extent, but it cannot be done in marine, so you need a signal that can travel longer,
which is VHF,
or very high frequency. But in order to do that, you need to compromise on quality. Old radio simplified it for us by only introducing AM and FM. AM traveled longer, FM had better clarity. Hence, you can see more FM channels than AM. This graph will help you understand the line I'm speaking of a little bit better. With SDR, the line is a lot bigger and covers more variety of signals and range, if you have the right equipment. In the SDR interface, signals have headers or some kind of notes to help you understand who uses that type of frequency. So it'll all make sense once you start using it. Where to buy it? Now, with that out of the way, let's get to the fun stuff. The buying process is fairly easy for everyone with almost no exceptions. I bought mine from AliExpress and the delivery took about 9 days. It's also available on Amazon, eBay, and crowdsupply.com. The main thing you should look for is buying an original RTL-SDR, as there are so many copycats, and the company that produces them makes a good effort in warning the buyers. I will leave a link in the description for all three major platforms with original devices. Which software to use? There are so many, but the one I'm using and the one that RTL-SDR recommends is SDR Sharp, which is a free to download and use third-party software. The software itself does not require admin rights. It can be installed, for lack of a better term, within the folder, otherwise known as standalone software, and does not get routed to your program file in your desktop, which is good if you're using a company laptop. Just be careful not to violate any policies. In the description, I will leave a link to an Android app version as well that can be used to achieve the same results. It's a great companion to have for a quick on-the-go setup and ease of use, but it lacks features that you can find in the SDR Sharp desktop version and can be frustrating to use sometimes. It's also not free and will require a purchase to get all the features. How to install? Installation can be done in less than 5 minutes. From your desktop, all you have to do is the following. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to go to airspy.com/downloads. Once you see this page, you want to click on the first option that says here download. And then what you want to do next, you want to have it in a folder, in a designated folder where you can easily access it, extract it. Once you extract it, just enter the folder and do the following. You want to click on install RTL-SDR. You're going to face, or you're going to see this window here. Just click more info and run anyway. Then you're going to see this window, command window. It's going to go through, it's going to scroll through a few things, and then it will give you this message. Just click press to continue. And then once you do that, you want to go to, you'll see that this file actually originally was not here and was only created once we did the installation. So what you want to do, you want to click it, click yes, and then here you can see that the list is empty. So now you want to plug in your device. As you can see, I plugged mine and it says one device found, but you click on options and you click list all devices, and then from this list, it may vary depending on your setup or the number of devices you have. Obviously, I have a lot, so you're seeing a lot. The one you want to pick is this one, Bulkin Interface Interface 0. And then it says reinstall drivers. If you're doing it for the first time, it will say install drivers. So I'm going to do it anyways. So we'll click reinstall. Usually takes about, from my experience, about a minute. All right, so you can see here now it says the driver was installed successfully. You click close this window. Now it's time to open it. So we're going to open it here, SDR Sharp. And then this is what it looks like. So first thing you want to do is you want to go to click on this option here, the three lines, and then click on source, and then click on RTL-SDR USB. It's not going to play by itself. Once you click it, you still need to click the start button. Once you click the start, you can start hearing the broadcast. So
So that's how you install it. Now I will just show you a few quick settings that are useful. Make sure that you go to layout, and then on the zoom bar, you select it. You will see that it's now, you have the option of zooming in on the signal, or basically controlling the layout, or, you know, it helps you to get the better, it helps you to narrow down a good signal. All right, so what you want to do is you want to go to the Play Store, type SDR Touch, and you will find three options. You want to click the one that says SDR Touch to go ahead and install it. Once that is done, you open it up and you click OK. And at this point, you want to plug your device using the OTG. You click the Start button on the top and you will see this message. It's basically telling you there are missing drivers. All you have to do is just click OK and it will take you to the Play Store. You click Install. Once it's installed, you unplug the device and then you plug it back again. It will say Open RTL. Just click OK and it should start right up. And that's it. Now, the spectrum, the one on the top right here, is a paid feature, meaning if you're using the free version, you can only use it for a certain period of time. I believe it's about 1 minute or so. So once that is done, it'll continue working, so you can continue receiving signal, but you won't be able to see the spectrum.
Physical features. When you buy the RTL-SDR, it comes in with everything you need to get started. The device itself is made out of metal and has a USB interface on one end and SMA port on the other. If you find yourself liking it, you can improve it later by buying accessories. While using it, it's normal for the device to get hot. The metal enclosure works as a heat dissipation or a heat sink, so don't worry. Signal strength. From my home, which is located about 17 kilometers from the nearest airport, I was able to pick up the following signals. The normal FM and AM radio stations or channels with high clarity and without doing anything special. Just plug the dongle, turn on the software, and tune into the desired frequency and start listening. I was also able to pick up random walkie-talkie signals. Some were clear and some were encrypted. We will talk about the encryption at a later part. I also picked up an automated aviation signal that broadcasts runway and weather information and sounded like this.
0100 ILS approach runway 30 in use, taxiway Bravo 1 foreclosed, net report wind touchdown zone 110 degrees 5 knots. Visibility, 3,500 meters. Haze, cloud, no significant clouds. Temperature, 1.8. Dew point, 1.5. QNH, 1.
I also managed to pick up aviation signals between planes and traffic control towers. But the signal was poor and unreliable, and the quality was bad. Even when the quality was good, it was only for a short period. The signals you heard at the beginning of the video were only possible when I was near the airport, roughly 2 to 5 kilometers away. All these signals were picked up using the provided kit without any modification. In theory, you can improve your signal scanning and quality by having a better antenna. But for the average person, you can achieve the same results you see in this video without spending any additional money on top of the $40 that costs to buy the device. Encrypted signals. Now, this is an advanced subject, but it's good to know the basics at least, so when you run into one, you will know that it's intended to be that way and not think that your signal is poor. Encrypted signals are used for secure communication and they sound like a broken or poor signal, but have almost no background noise. They can be decrypted using certain software, which you can find videos on YouTube. What can you pick up with it? Well, besides commercial radio stations, aviation signals, weather forecasts, you can also pick up walkie-talkie signals, marine signals, which I'm yet to try, and almost any signal you can think of. Just a quick note on the weather forecast channels. They're not available in every country and is mostly government-owned stations to broadcast weather information and warn against natural disasters. So don't be disappointed if you can't find one. Legality. Now, this is a subject depending on your geolocation. Common sense says that it's perfectly legal, as you're only receiving and not sending any signals. And the burden of protecting the signals falls on those who transmits the signal in the first place. But I would strongly recommend checking your laws to make sure you're not breaking any. I absolutely loved spending time with it. It certainly brought back old memories, and it's a fun little project. I'm intending to use it as a normal radio on my desk, as it adds a nice retro look and it makes me look smart. This is it. If this video helped you get started, I would absolutely love to hear about your experience. And if you're running into any issues, I would love to help if I can. This video was produced after testing and spending about 1 week only. So if you're an expert on the subject and want to correct anything that I said in the video that's not correct, feel free to do so. If you lasted this long, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.